If you wish, your home assistant could tell the difference between a working and non-working days, you're in the right place. But here is the twist. I'm not talking about the regular weekends here, but for your region-specific public holidays and other custom dates that you can easily configure and use in your automations. For that, I will show you how the Home Assistant Workday integration works, and also I will show three easy and useful home automations that you can start using right away. Let's start with the Workday integration first, as it will provide a nice little sensor that we are going to use. This is my test Home Assistant, and to add the Workday integration, I'll press the C key on my keyboard to invoke this dialog, and I'll search for integrations, then I'll select navigate integrations, and I'll add a new one. I'll search for Workday here. Here it is, Workday. I'll select it. I can name it whatever I wish, but I'll leave the default one. And from this drop-down, I'll search for my country. You can find yours here. Here it is, Bulgaria. And I'll click on Submit. For Bulgaria, for example, only school calendars are added at the moment, which is okay. Here on this dialog, I can set few options, which are nice to have. I can exclude some specific days, I can include some, whatever I wish. I can set an offset, and here is one interesting field. In this one, I can add custom holidays. If you have an official site in your country that is listing all of the holidays that are going to happen this year, you can get the dates from there, and you can ask any AI like ChatGPT or Google Gemini or whatever, your favorite AI, you can ask to convert it in this format. Full year, months and days. Once you convert your holidays in this format, you can add them here by just pasting them. For example, I can add tomorrow, which is Friday, as a holiday. Just for the test. Yes, this is tomorrow. And I can use comma as separator. If I want to add a range here, I can type, for example, that way this range will be included as a holiday from 26th of October till 30. Like that. And that's okay. I can remove holidays from this list. For example, I can remove only one day from this range if I wish, and I also can change the language here, and I also can add additional categories, holidays. As you saw, only school calendar is available for my country, so I'll add it just in case, and I'll click Submit. This is it, my workday is now ready to be used. I'll just click on Skip and Finish. And now I have a workday sensor, which is a binary sensor that can be either on or off. And when it is on, that means today is a working day. If it is off, it is a holiday. I can also see that in the calendar. Look at that. Today is a working day. Tomorrow is a holiday because I said so. The Saturday and Sunday are not working days. And then the range that I set in the custom field initially. Every other day is a work day, and that's pretty fine. If I go in December, for example, I can see that Christmas is also a holiday. That means everything seems fine. And that is the key part for the automations to work. Time for automations. Let's start simple, but here is the thing. Even this first and basic automation has a twist that most people miss. And I will show you that in just a second. I will show the upcoming automations in both Visual Editor and YAML. And listen, I know copying YAML code from video is painful. You pause, rewind, mistype a space, everything breaks. We've all been there. So, I've created a free PDF guide with all automations we are covering today. Plus, detailed explanations and troubleshooting tips. To grab it, just open the link in the video description, type your name and email address, you will receive a mail from me where you can confirm you are a real human and not some rogue smart bot. Finally, you get instant access to all the code, nicely formatted and ready to copy paste. Trust me, you will want this for automation number 3, which is a real YAML beast. Alright, let's keep moving because automation number 1 is fast, easy and useful. I'm calling this one a light alarm. No more accidentally waking up at 6 a.m. on your national holiday because you forgot to disable your alarm. This automation only triggers your wake-up routine on real work days. I'll open the automation section of Home Assistant. For that, I'll press the C button. I'll type automations and I'll select navigate automations. And here are my workday automations. I'll start with this first one. I'll enable it because I keep them disabled before the demo. And this is it. This is the YAML code. This is how it is looking like. And this is the visual editor. Every day at 6:30 in the morning, this automation will be triggered. And if the condition is met, and the condition here is our workday sensor. If this is on, that means if today is a workday, then perform a light turn on action. Simple as that. With that automation, you can check at any time, is it a workday or not? And if it is, you can turn on some lights to wake you up. Let me show you one interesting line. Editing YAML. Now, here is that twist I mentioned. See that transition time? Set it to 300 seconds and your lights will gradually fade in over 5 minutes, mimicking a sunrise. This transition will turn on your light, if that is supported by your light, to full brightness within 300 seconds. Nice little touch, don't you think? Let's quickly test it, but because now it's not 6:30 in the morning, I'll add another trigger. Very quickly, this trigger will be start automation. This one, this is an input button, a helper that I added as a button on my dashboard. And once this button is pressed, it will activate this automation. Simple as that. I'll hit save and I'll show you the button. This is it, start automation button. And if I press it, and if I go back, I'll see that this trigger is activated. And also the bedroom light is turned at 100%, which is exactly what I wanted. If I go back, if I check the traces, I can see that the binary sensor workday is currently on and the wanted state is on. So that means it executed the action. Now, we are about to transition to the next automation. But first, if you're getting value from this video so far, do me a huge favor, hit that subscribe button, like it owes you money. It helps the algorithm show this video to other Home Assistant fans who need these automations as well. Plus, I drop a new Home Assistant tutorial regularly and you don't want to miss what's coming next. Alright, let's get into the intermediate territory with automation 2 from today's video. You can check if tomorrow or some other future date is a work day. Then schedule something. Actually, anything. Here is how. I will disable this automation and I'll enable the next one, which is check if tomorrow is a working day and notify. Let's open it. Again, the trigger is specific time, for example, 8 p.m. But because now it's not 8 p.m. and because I want to test this automation as well, I'll enable this automation. Again, I'll use this same button to trigger the automation. This is a helper input button that can be created from helpers menu. I'm quickly showing you that. Create helper button, and you can type whatever you wish as a name here, and you can create it, and then you can use it as a button to test your automations. That's what I'm doing right now. I have no conditions here. And as actions, I have several things. If Workday is on, but not for today, but for tomorrow, that is now plus 1 day. If I changed here 2 days, that will be 2 days from now, but I'll leave it one for the test. And if tomorrow is a working day, store the result of this template in this response variable called result. And then in the next action, which is if then else statement, check if the result is true with this template. And if the result is true, then create a persistent notification that will be shown here in the notification section of Home Assistant. The text of this persistent notification will be tomorrow is a work day, don't forget your meeting. For example, it can be anything. Of course, I can add more actions here. Anything, I can do whatever I wish. This is just a demo and I want to show you how you can easily check tomorrow what day it is. Is it a work day or holiday? And depending of what it is, you can either send tomorrow is a work day, or if it is not, I will receive tomorrow is not a working day, enjoy. So let's test this. I'll hit save and I will click the button on my dashboard to start this automation. And immediately I'm receiving a notification. Tomorrow is not a working day, enjoy. Relax tomorrow. That is this else statement. Again, I can add more actions here. I can start and stop devices. I can turn on or off lights, whatever I wish. But this is just a demo. And if I go to traces of this automation, I can see that the result response variable is having a false state, which means tomorrow is not a work day, and this if checks that, result is false, and execute these actions, which is sent a persistent notification, tomorrow is not a working day. To check some other day in the future, I can go back, I can change this template a bit. For example, with 14 days, I'll increase the time with 14 days, not tomorrow, but 14 days after now. I hope it will be a work day to then. So let's check it one more time. I'll go back to my, I'll delete this and I'll click on the start automation button again. This is the notification and I got the other message. Tomorrow is a working day. Actually, this is not a tomorrow, but 14 days after now. And 14 days after now is a work day and I have this as info, which is great. And you can play around as long as you wish with these things. They are yours to have. And now let's keep moving because automation number 3 has a story you need to hear. But before that, the subscribe button is looking pretty good right now. Just saying. Okay, story time. Last year, I flied out of the door on a Monday morning, drove 45 minutes to the office, walked into the building, reached for my phone and nothing, empty pocket. I had left it charging at home. That 90 minute round trip cost me nerves, time and money. Never again. This automation check if it is a workday morning and remind you to grab essential items before you leave. You can customize it for anything, laptop, keys, lunch, your dignity, whatever. I'll disable the previous automation and I'll go to the next one, which is this one, Work Essentials Reminder. Automation is disabled, I'll enable it because I want to test it and demo it. The trigger here is when the door is unlocked. It becomes from locked to unlocked. This is the trigger. I have 3 conditions. The first one is, as usual, workday sensor have to be on. That means today is a workday. So as this is the first condition. If today is a workday, and if the time is before 9 a.m., and if my phone's battery is charging, and if all these 3 things are true, then execute these actions. The actions are persistent notification create. I'll receive a notification here in the notification section with this text, don't forget your phone. And I also execute this repeat 5 times action. The actions are the following. Turn on the light in the entry light to color red. Delay 1 second, then turn it off. Delay 1 second, and this will be repeated 5 times. It will be something like red flashing light. And I also will send a notification. And that is just a demo. You can change it to whatever you wish. Let's test it. Let me open my Home Assistant dashboard. I'll clear the notifications. Currently the door is locked. Currently the entry light is on, but it is in blue. And if I unlock the door right now, but I have to change a few things here because right now it is not before 9 a.m. It is much later. And I also have to put my phone to charge. So let me put my phone to charge first. Okay. And now I have to change this a bit before 9 p.m. for example. And I'll save this automation. Now the trigger is the same if the door becomes unlocked, if today is a work day, and if the time is before 9 p.m. and if my battery phone is charging, then execute these actions. So let's see what will happen with this entry light if I unlock my door. It is on, off, on. Great, it is working. The light is flashing because of this repeat and because today is a work day. This is the YAML code and this is the trace of the automation. The front door becomes unlocked. The first condition is true because the workday sensor is on and I wanted that. The second condition is also true because it is after, it is before 9 p.m. and current time is 7:30, and and the third condition was my phone to be in charging state. This is the case right now because I plugged my phone into the charger and the first action is executed, which is don't forget your phone. I forgot to check this, but it worked obviously. And the next action are repeat, 5 time repeats of turn on and off the light with some delay. I know, I said 3 automations, but guess what? There is a bonus. Actually, scratch that. There are 3 more automations using the Home Assistant Workday integration, and they're just as good as the ones in the video. Each one comes with a full explanation and a complete YAML code, all formatted nice and clean, so you can just copy and paste. Remember that free PDF I mentioned earlier? Well, that's where these bonus automations are hiding, and the link's in the description. Seriously, grab it now before you scroll away and forget about it. If you made it this far, you're the real MVP. Drop a comment telling me which automation you're implementing first, or if you have your own workday automation that I missed, I want to hear about it. I'm Kirill, thanks for watching, bye!